Welcome to another episode of With Enough Prep Time. I'm the Nerd Man, and today I'm going to be talking about one sexy motherfucker, Henry Cavill, and everybody wants his ass back as Superman. As Superman, has he got some sense super in his pants? Everyone wants to bang Henry Cavill apparently, and I'm not falling for it. I don't want Henry Cavill back as Superman. I'm gonna tell you why in this video. A lot of excuses are made for him, a lot of, you know, and I know I'm gonna get a million dislikes for this video. If a million people watch it, probably five people will watch it and they will all dislike it. But let's go through this. So why do I think, there's two or three main reasons. So I'm just going to make sure I have it down. There's three main reasons why I think that Henry Cavill's day of Superman has gone and passed, and we should just get over it and look forward to a new direction. A bunch of fans of DC and fans of the new take on Superman are clamoring for Henry Cavill to come back. They say he's ripped right from the pages of the comic. He looks like Superman, and therefore he should play Superman. He looks more like what you see when you see the comic with the chiseled, muscled figure. Well, I say that is not the best Superman. It's not a relatable Superman. And it's not a Superman that is popular within the popular culture, apart from on, you know, fans on YouTube. People did not like nor get his Superman. And one of the reasons I think is a problem with Cavill is not Cavill himself. Cavill's a good actor, decent actor, not a great actor. A decent actor, from what I've seen. He still has not managed, for me, to translate his charisma, which I have seen him display in interviews. He's still not managed to carry that charisma over to screen. He's a bit straight-faced, a bit, you know, wooden, would I say, when it comes to his acting. And he has almost three or four expressions in most of his roles. I understand why people love him, though. And I understand that he does look like some, you know, drawings or depictions of Superman in the comic. Here's the problem, though. He was cast for Superman. Zack Snyder had a vision and cast him for Superman rather than casting him for Clark Kent. And it is a mistake, easily, that any of us could have made. So I'm not blaming Zack Snyder for this. I would have looked at Henry Cavill in the Superman suit if they had brought Henry Cavill to me. And I would have looked at him in Tudors and I would have saw him, and I probably would have done a better job of using Henry Cavill as Superman, to be honest. But I would have looked at him and thought, you know what? That's great, great for Superman. What I would have been forgetting is the equally important component to the Superman story, which is Clark Kent. Clark Kent, the mild-mannered reporter. The reporter that disappears into the background, that nobody notices, that Lois overlooks. Amy Adams herself has said how much of a hot guy, how much of a babe Henry Cavill is, how she can't stop looking and touching him on set. This is not a man to play Clark Kent. The beauty of what Christopher Reeves did, And we, you know, you can, I can say it till I'm blue in the face. I do not want somebody doing a Christopher Reeves impression coming back. But the beauty of what Christopher Reeves did was make you believe that this guy, you know, Superman was a complete stud, but Clark Kent was a complete geek who you could genuinely overlook. Okay? And I don't think Cavill has that in him. And I think Cavill would be better suited to go into another, like, continue on a slight kind of adjacent continuation of the Snyderverse by doing a Red Son movie where he only has to play Superman. Yeah? So you can keep him on and honor, you know, your contractor, allowing him to continue playing Superman since he looked like he was going into an evil Superman anyway. And then let him do an Injustice version of Superman where he faces off against a new, younger, more vulnerable Superman than he himself is. So looks is an important part. Secondly, the problem with this Superman is he has been deconstructed from the beginning. And he's given a bad taste and left a bad flavor on all the characters involved in his mythos. And because of that, that whole aspect of the Snyder universe has capsized so spectacularly that the actors involved in the Superman universe, i.e. his supporting cast, are not there anymore. So where is this Clark? Is this Clark Kent Superman going to work in the Daily Planet? Is Perry White going to be there? Are they going to recast everyone else around apart from apart from Henry Cavill, right? Because you want to bring Henry Cavill back, right? Just, and not even with any kind of smart reason of how you're going to bring him back. Are we going to have him face Brainiac? So another alien invasion Superman with Henry Cavill. This Superman has been deconstructed, and it's problematic as a deconstructed Superman. And then when he came back as the all-powerful Superman Prime, who can destroy everyone, Steppenwolf, he can destroy the entire Justice League by himself, right? When you have that Superman, Superman Prime, as I like to call him, he was useless. This Christopher Reeves rip-off Superman who can do everything the Justice League can do combined, trash. Absolute trash. This is why people think Superman is boring. Cavill's Superman, both versions, is why people hate, general public, people think that Batman is cooler. This is why it is not Christopher Reeve's Superman. It is this Superman. This Superman who can do anything the Justice League can do, is as powerful as everyone, is super, everything. And is just, just a copy of Christopher Reeves. And a bad imitation at that. This is not a good Superman to go forward with. It is not a Superman that fits our times. They need to go back to the drawing board and find somebody who can do a dual Superman Clark Kent and make you believe in Clark Kent, but also do something different from Christopher Reeves. Give us our version, our time Superman. Not the 70s Superman. And an all-powerful one who can't be beaten by anything. And then giving him a movie where he's going to fight Black Adam potentially is a disaster waiting to happen. If you are a Superman fan, that will single-handedly throw Superman down the toilet. And nobody will ever like him again. You won't be able to have another Superman movie. That is what will happen if you put Superman up against Black Adam. Because that is going to be as trash a movie as Aquaman. That is the level of movie that you are going. It will be Fast and Furious Superman. It's a bad, bad idea. They need to go back to basics with Superman. Start with a year two, year one interpretation with a younger Superman that people can relate to. A Superman who is an intern at the Daily Planet, who doesn't turn up to the Daily Planet with no qualifications whatsoever and become one of the top reporters, and stringers for one of the biggest international newspapers in the world. Essentially, the New York Times of the DC Universe. A guy walks in who's been fishing for the last 10 years and walks in with no qualifications and becomes one of the top guys there. Is that believable? Is that a Superman you can relate to? This is a Superman with no problems, no issues. He's so powerful, he can do anything. I've never understood why Superman is boring from reading the comics and watching Lois and Clark and being a big fan of the Chris Reeves era. I've never understood why Superman is so boring until watching Henry Cavill. He is not Superman, a main continuity Superman. He just isn't. Okay, last thing. You fans who are holding us back because maybe you're Snyder fans, or maybe you're the fans of what Cavill did in the Justice League, which made no money and nobody went to see. Okay, the Justice League. With your big new Superman. Nobody went to see. Film ruined Wonder Woman's momentum. As everyone was thinking, oh, this girl's gangster. Maybe she can even take on... Nope. She can't take on Superman. She's probably weaker than Aquaman. They've relegated Wonder Woman to the Black Widow of the team. When she was a gangster... In Batman vs Superman, all to elevate Cavill Superman, and what happened wasn't elevated. Nobody went to see the movie, and the most they remember about him is his lip. He's done. His cast, his supporting cast, have moved on. Lastly, you're holding us back from doing what they're doing with. This is going to, and I guarantee you, this new Batman movie is going to surprise people. It's going to be one of the greatest Batman movies ever. Possibly even taking on something like The Dark Knight. I think it's going to be that good. The people behind it, the filmmaker behind it, I haven't seen his Apes movies, but I've seen his earlier movies, and this guy is a great, great filmmaker. And you're once again, you're going to be letting him set the trend. Be the greatest of all, so that everyone's always so that Warner Brothers will be like not interested in Superman, because they'll do a Superman versus Black Adam, and people will be like, man, what the hell is this? Black Adam's supposed to be a villain who has an organic relationship with Shazam. He's fighting Superman instead of Superman fighting Brainiac, who everyone wants to see. That's what they should be setting up. A younger, less experienced, less powerful Superman who becomes an intern at the Daily Planet, something that we can relate to in this day and age, instead of somebody just walking into the Daily Planet, getting a job like anything. Somebody who's young, hungry, wants to be is an intern at the Daily Planet, is being mistreated by Perry, who, Lois doesn't like, a Clark Kent that people can relate to. And then people will love the Superman after that, but for being the savior, the hopeful, the whatever. And if you get a younger guy, something that matches the tone and what they're going for in this new Batman universe, which I 100%, and I'm a huge Wonder Woman fan. I think it's going to be better than Wonder Woman. I think the next Batman movie is going to be better than anything in the DCEU universe to date. I think maybe the only movie that might be able to challenge it is The Joker. I want that level of cinema for Superman and Wonder Woman. I want another Wonder Woman, a younger Wonder Woman, to match this Batman who is, you know, comes from Themyscira, you know, and meets Steve Trevor in this timeline in 2020. A Wonder Woman who meets Steve Trevor in 2020 and start a trilogy after Patty Jenkins is done with hers. Hopefully that soon enough. And in the meantime, reboot Superman. Young Superman, 22 tops. Go maybe the same way that the Darren Criss new Superman Man of Tomorrow is going. Have him face someone not so great in the first movie, but set up Brainiac for the second movie. And that is it. That is what you should be focused on. Getting a match, a gel to what is going to be, I think, we're going to see something like this Patterson Batman universe being a start for a whole new universe, including the Joker. And I hope it includes Superman, and I hope it includes Wonder Woman. But, you know, you guys are holding it back because Cavill, oh, he's so good looking. And I like Cavill, I like his personality, I like the fact that he's so passionate about Superman. Have nothing against the guy, he's great. He is not what Superman needs right now. And saying, oh, he should be given a chance because, you know, this. He hasn't made a profitable Superman movie yet. He's actually made a movie that is even in the red in terms of, losing the studio money. Okay, as Superman. I think the studio should be loyal to him. And let him do something like a Red Sun Superman or something like that. But in terms of playing main continuity Superman, if Warner Brothers puts Cavill in again, they are stupid. If they cave in to these fans who don't even know what they want until they see it, and then when they see it, they'll be like, oh my god, this is excellent. Need the new Superman. Reboot the whole thing. Get a new cast, new, fresh, young, a cool cast. And forget the Pa Kent and all of that of past. That's what you need to do. That is, ultimately, you want a Superman that is equivalent to what the other guy is doing with the Batman movies right now. Younger, fresher, new age. Something like that, and get Superman right this time first off the bat. So that's my position on Cavill. I know everyone fancies him and are attracted to him and all of that. I am too. I think he's very good looking. I like him with his shirt off, but ain't good enough. And this is not Make-A-Wish. He's got a brilliant career. I don't feel sorry for him. He's going to have a lot of great movies and a lot of great TV shows and a lot of hot women to make up for the fact that he just ain't Superman anymore. Don't feel sorry for him. This isn't like somebody losing their job at a factory. This is Cavill, world famous actor, losing the role of Superman, even though he's a much sought after commodity. So forget about it. He'll be fine. And I believe he'll be fine. I believe in him. And I hope the best for you, Cavill, as well. Nothing against you. Just how I feel. Please like, comment, subscribe. Tell me if you enjoyed this rant. Thank you very much. Have a good day.